Ciao friends! Today I want to show you how to compute a total by summing values row by row. And I want to do that by starting with a wrong measure. Let's take a look at this report. In this report I'm showing the sales amount by several months in 2007 and then I'm computing the sales per working day, which is the amount of sales divided by the number of working days month by month. The number is wrong, and how do we know it? Well, sales per working day should look like some sort of average, but all the values in every month is greater than 4,000, and it's kind of weird that the last value, the average over the entire year, is less than 4,000. Where is the problem? Well, the problem is that sales per working day is defined as the sales amount divided by the number of working days. So the measure by itself is just a simple division. Working days might be the problem. In order to debug it, we just take working days and we put it in the report to see the different values. If we do that, we put working days in the report, and you see that we have sales amount, we have working days, and the problem becomes clear. We are dividing the sales amount, which is 885, divided by 261 days, many more than the working days month by month. I'm taking into account values which should not be considered. And the reason I don't want to consider them is because I don't have sales. Now, you can hide this value in an easy way, because if I want to remove working days from the report, an if statement is more than enough. I can just use an if statement that checks if sales amount is greater than zero, then I compute the number of working days, otherwise I blank it out. And as a result, you see that now the number is no longer visible, but still the total is wrong. Why that? Well, even if we're not showing the value row by row, we are still taking that into account at the grand total. So what I want to do is, instead of doing the calculation only at the total level, I want to move the calculation row by row, perform the calculation there, and then aggregate the result. What am I doing if I do an operation step by step, month by month? I'm iterating. And I'm iterating over what? Over the month. So I need to replace my calculation, and instead of doing a simple formula like this, I want to iterate it month by month. So what I need to do is replace these working days with a different calculation, that is a sum x, over the values of what? Well, in my report I have the month, but in order to make sure that it will work also across multiple years, I would like to use a column that contains both the year and the month in the same column, so that I will always iterate on different values. So I iterate over the values of calendar, year, month, and then I use calculate to perform context transition and force the entire calculation to only the current month. I need to format the code the right way. These need to be there. Now looks much nicer. And by doing that, I do an iteration month by month, and I compute the sales amount and the number of working days only if there are sales month by month. If you take a look at the total, it was 261, now it's 152, which happens to be exactly the sum of the values row by row. And of course, my original measure, which divides sales amount by number of working days, is now computing the right number. Have fun with DAX!